Okay, guys, so if you saw my earlier video, I got this off the beach along the Fraser River. Fraser River's pretty muddy. It's mud, not sand. Well, there is some sand, but whatever. So you can see here that my cuts weren't straight. Really, who cares? It's an outdoor planter piece it's a double piece. Here I wrote beautiful, here I wrote life. Beautiful life, okay? I'm gonna be using my cut saw once again. Extreme Flame Burr. If you want to look at the website or buy these burrs and save yourself 5%, follow the link below, guys, and use the code CFUSION. I love these burrs because they outlast all the others and they're more aggressive. They call me Heavy Hands. So yeah, I'm just going to carve in these letters. My writing's not the best, but it doesn't have to be the best because she's known me for a long time and she knows I was a brat in school, so I didn't do too much writing in school. Beautiful. Life. Okay, there you can see I got all my carving done in with my chicken scratch writing. Yeah, I could have used a template, guys, and got my writing perfect and traced the lines, but I think this is good enough. It's more me for her, right? And anyways, excuse me. What I'm gonna do now is use my Dremel with the cutsaw. Follow the link below, guys. Cutsaw and use code CFUSION. I'm gonna use this. I'm gonna make some round edges down here, like wind lines. I might do a wood spirit in here too, I think. That is good luck. Maybe one here and one here too. Just a quick one, nothing crazy. Beautiful life. So I'm sure when I was doing the carving, maybe some of you have realized that I forgot to put the eye in here. But I'm going to leave it the way it is, and I'll tell you in a minute I'm going to leave it the way it is. So there's an L there too. I should have started a bit more over here, but it's not a big deal, guys. It's an outside piece. You can see a wood spirit put in here. I carved love in here for the lady, a flower, and just some lines and stuff like that to liven it up. So, I just want to talk a quick second about this carving. I knew it was going to be a carving for my friend's parents since I woke up this morning. Actually, last week when I seen this double connected stump together, I knew I was going to carve it for my friend's mom. My friend's name's Doug. he's been my best friend for, like, you know how we all have best friends and best friends? But he's one of my best friends. I have, like, three best friends, and he's one of them. And his dad just passed away. And I just wanted to make this piece for his mom. His dad was a great man. He was, excuse me, that's from the cold that I had yesterday. His dad was a longshoreman many of years in the same locals that I'm in. He was a member, a retired member in Local 502, International Longshoremen's Union. He was a mechanic. He was a great man. When I was a little shithead in my younger days, and nobody's parents really liked me, because I was just a little shit. I seen him at the gas station one day, and I was limping. And he goes, oh, I said, hey, Mr. Snowbart. He goes, how are you doing, Jordy? I says, oh, I'm doing okay. I can't work right now because my knee's all screwed up. Well, what? Come on over to the house, and I got an extra knee brace I'll give you. And I kind of felt awkward, but I was like, yeah, sure, okay, I'll take that. Sure. So I went over to his house, and Doug wasn't there, but he came out with a knee brace. I think it might have been Doug's knee brace or something. But, you know, from that day on, we kind of not become friends, but, you know, I had a respect for him, and he had a lot of respect for me, too, I guess. I don't know. It's weird the way the world works. Certain people gravitate towards certain people. Anyways, Doug was there the day I fell off the roof. Doug, like, saw me pretty well dead, but I'm not going to get into that too much. But, you know, Doug, I'm going to send you a link to this video, and I just want you to know that I love you, man, and I'm really sorry about your dad. And I hope that's why I'm not going to change this spelling on here, because you used to bug me about my spelling all the time, so I'm just going to leave it. Beautiful. It's beautiful life. Next time you go to the island, buddy, come and pick up this planter box and give it to your mom. Maybe she'll like it in her garden and it can remind her of your dad or something like that. It's just a gesture for me to say I'm sorry for the loss of your father, man. I know it sucks, and but you just have to keep living, I guess, man. You know? And all the other people out there, too. Like, I didn't spend much time carving this. Like, what, a couple hours? I spent a lot of time getting this out of the... waking up today, going for the drive to get this piece and pulling it out and cutting it on site. I knew every second I was making this for Mr. Stobart. For Mr. Stobart. Well, Mrs. Stobart, Doug's mom. I knew that, and I worked hard for it. Because, do you know why? I'm pretty sure Mr. Stobart, or Doug, my best friend, would have done the same for me. And that's why I made this box. Come and get the flower box, bro. I hope your mom will like it.